We do want to go now to Action News reporter Tom Miller, who continues our team coverage. And Tom, yesterday the main concern was drivers struggling to keep their cars on the road, but today it seems as though those same problems have multiplied, and with those, you got a lot of major power outages.
That's right, Brittany. At the peak, around 4,700 PG&E customers were without power here in Santa Cruz County, with 4,200 of those being in Santa Cruz, in the Santa Cruz Mountains. But now, after this storm has rolled through, the focus shifts to recovery.
Trees toppled, lines downed, and thousands were without power. This, the aftermath of the latest storm in the Santa Cruz Mountains.
When you hear about small pockets that still don't have power, well, that's us.
While some drivers follow the signs and turn around here in Felton, others risk it and sneak their cars under this uprooted tree propped up by active power lines.
Pretty typical. Yeah, there's all kinds of canopies of trees during storms like this.
Meanwhile, just north of Scotts Valley, a landslide takes out part of Vine Hill Road, causing headaches for drivers and at least one property owner.
I just watched the road just break off and fall away and wash down my property into the creek, and I've lost several trees.
A flash flood warning went into effect Sunday morning before being lifted just hours later. But that's not stopping people from keeping an eye on rivers known to cause damage. As for the San Lorenzo Valley River, right now it's at about 15 feet, high enough to pick up loose debris, but it would need to rise another 3 feet for these homes behind us to be threatened here in Felton Grove. These brothers live nearby and want to see firsthand whether or not the river will creep up to their home, a lesson learned after a close call 2 years ago.
We're kind of worried of it going inside, but it stopped raining for that.
From inside the County Emergency Operations Center, Paul Horvat monitors all the action and isn't worried about the river.
We're not expecting any heavy rainfall, so that river should drop, and we're not anticipating any evacuations.
Back in the San Lorenzo Valley, PG&E grounded its crews after high winds created dangerous conditions. By mid-afternoon, things calmed down and the work resumed. But the road to recovery remains a long one.
And at last check, 950 customers remain without power in the Santa Cruz Mountains. As for that sinkhole, Vine Hill Road will be closed at least through tomorrow and really until any permanent fix is put into place. Brittany.
Tom, thank you. That's some impressive video we saw there.